Hi, I'm Flight Sergeant Tony Kyle, member of the Medical Emergency Response Team based in Camp Bastion. On board of the MERT team, we've actually got four medical personnel, a doctor, two paramedics and an emergency nurse, which I am. Our day starts at 9 o'clock in the morning, where we meet at the aircraft and get prepped for the full 24 hours. We do 24 hours on call and then 24 hours on standby. The start of the day today, we handed over from the first team that have been on overnight. We quickly got a shout to a patient that had been injured, a local national patient. The aircraft was airborne within 3 or 4 minutes of getting the report through with the injuries for that casualty. When we got airborne, we started to prep all of the kit ready to receive the casualty. We had a good few minutes to do that. On landing on, the patient was brought to us by the ground call sign. The Force Protection RAF Regiment got off the back to make sure that the area was secure, and one of our paramedics also got off to take over the handover for the patient. On receiving the patient onto the aircraft, we quickly took off with a good few minutes, 5 or 6 minutes, to get back to Bastion, to the hospital. In flight, we assessed the patient and treated appropriately with this particular injury. The guys on the ground had packaged them very well, and therefore it was plain sailing and a reasonably safe journey back to Bastion. Upon getting back to Bastion, we offloaded the casualty with help from the fire crew on the ground, and he was taken into the hospital where he's received further treatment. The next mission that we were asked to go to, we got a report of two casualties. At the point of that, we weren't told any other information, so we prepped the kit as for two casualties. While we were in flight, it was quite apparent that there was still a conflict going on the ground and that there was a firefight in progress. So because of that, we had to hold overhead until they could make the area secure for the Chinook to land. We received two casualties onto the back of the helicopter, and they were relatively stable. Luckily, we managed to get back to Bastion safe. Although on the way back we did have a bird strike, which was interesting. Going back to the patient, the two patients that were on board were dealt with quite quickly by the doctor and the two paramedics, and we were able to get them back to Bastion in a safe and effective manner. This is my second tour out here on MERT, and obviously every time you come out here it brings with it its own challenges. The job itself is massively rewarding, but we do appreciate that we are going to pick up seriously injured patients, and because we are busy, that means that the guys on the ground are getting injured. It's an absolute fantastic job, and it's a pleasure to work on the MERT. Something that you'll never get in any job, in any walk of life back in the UK. With that though, there are challenges, there are stresses, and every day we have a mixture of emotions. Sometimes you feel like crying, sometimes you feel like laughing, and it's that team approach, and it's the guys that help you out throughout every single day, because you don't really get any chance to settle. Even on your standby days, you're wondering whether you're going to be called in to do some work. So from that point of view, it's been absolutely fantastic, but it's been shattering as well. And the 2 or 3 months that we do out here is hard work. But when you go back and you reflect on what has happened, you appreciate what a great job everybody on MERT does.